Here we bumped it up to 240 inches a minute. I'm up to just a little bit short of 7 on the volt dial. That's about all farther I want to take this machine and do any welding with it while it's hooked up to 110. It's not really enough to weld 10 gauge T joints right, but I'm going to see how it goes. It is pretty capable though. I'll just try a pull and fill to see if it's got the balls to do it right and it's going the way you should. And then I'll flip it and see if I can put a little signature on it. Or get it to loop without complaining. I can't watch the puddle because I get in the way of the camera, and I was trying to outrun it there because it kept filling back up and shortening the arc. The welder doesn't much like that. Yeah, it's not too bad. It's not biting deep. Although it did try to go through on the top plate on that side. Brush it off a little bit and see if I can get a signature. I'll turn it back down to 100 inches or 200 inches, about 100 amp. That should have been about 120 amps. And just roll my dial back to about 6 and see what the wide world of sports I can come up with there. I'll go away from my eyes and towards my eyes. I don't want that meeting of those. This weld is what they call a flock of knobs, and they're little bitty knobs for my big fat fingers. Let's see what happens. Big on the bottom leg. Better when I was pushing than what I did was pulling. I can pull it longer. I got more courage that way because I can see the backside fill. That isn't a weld you'd want to make on a structural member, but on 120, and once I got warmed up, it was moving